Welcome to Crowley House Flower Farm. Today we're going to kind of go through the process of what we did with the yurt and how we kind of just did the remodel.
Yes, we're super excited to share with you this spontaneous, it was kind of a spontaneous project here on the farm. And so we're going to take you through kind of what Jason envisioned and put together while you were unemployed.
Right?
Yeah. I was super excited that you were going to be like working on the flower farm with me, and I totally lost him. And yeah.
What? Well, it took me a month to do
it.
But
it did.
Yeah,
anyways.
The other 2 months that I was laid off to do other stuff. But.
No. I didn't get him. Well, I got you a little bit, but not much.
Yeah.
He planted the roses for me. did do that.
502 of them.
He's very proud of it. So anyways, today we thought we would just show you a little bit of some of the projects we do, or did, I guess, on the farm. Okay, so today we thought we would talk a little bit about our property. We have a very special something on our property that people always ask us about. So we thought we'd just address it right away because you'll probably see it in some of our videos. We have a yurt, a Pacific yurt.
It's the largest one they make. It's the 30-foot diameter yurt.
So we have this beautiful 1870-ish farmhouse, and then there was this yurt that is purple just off to the side, and then we had this like pink and yellow and something chicken coop. This place was very, very vibrant when we came, but the yurt, we just didn't quite, I mean, we didn't really need it, so we didn't know what to do with it.
We used it for, well, the last thing we did with it before we remodeled it was use it for storage for a lot of your decor stuff. I've just junked it. I just stick it in the yurt kind of thing. And then,
yeah, well, okay, so we came from like our house. So we built 2 homes before we came to this house.
Right.
So it was like
2,300 square feet.
Yeah.
You know, built.
3-car garage. Yeah. We had tons of storage. We had 2 kids younger at that time. And we come here to it. Old homes have absolutely no storage.
Yeah,
so we were
1,700 square foot.
Yeah. Home. Old home. With no storage. So we used the yurt for a long time. Then we slowly started like purging through and getting rid of. And I used it a lot for like vases and just, we had decor stuff that we would use, fabric and all that kind of stuff. And then
your sister moved in for,
Yeah,
she moved in there and lived in there for a couple of years and with her boyfriend. And they started building a deck out back, which was just pretty, it's a big deck. It probably, I don't know, it's 16 by 16.
Yeah.
It is. So it's.
So he just got the first little landing done. And then we just actually finished it up, what, a month or two ago or 3 months ago?
Summer.
Yeah. So I used the yurt for wreath making a couple years ago. It was just so cold, and we were able to, there was an old fireplace in there and
wood
everything.
Stove.
Well, yeah, wood stove. So we used it for wreath making, and we also went and got, or my sister came and lived with us for a while, and she was kind of like, oh, thank you, hon. She lived with us, and she was kind of like our farm help when I first started. And her boyfriend and her, they did some work to the yurt. They kind of started building a deck on the back. And
sorry,
what you drinking, honey?
Well, this is a wine, 2014 Pinot Noir from J.L. Kiff. They're out of McMinnville, Yamhill Carlton region. They're really good friends of ours. They have like 7 acres of grapes and husband and wife.
Yeah.
And they kind of
they're like the sweetest people ever. And they do, like, I love them because they are legit. Like, they do everything from top to bottom. Like, it is them out there and their kids, kind of like our farm. Yeah. So we can totally relate to them. But yeah, I've been sipping on it for, well, I've had a glass.
Wine enthusiasts gave it like 92 points. Wine enthusiasts, so that's a pretty good score.
And their kids, like all their kids are such amazing artists. They like do all the artistry work on it.
Yeah, all their labels are
designed by their two kids. I know, they're so talented. Anyways.
Anyway, sorry to get off on that rant, but
cheers. Okay, cheers to the year. My sister's boyfriend started the back deck. He did an amazing job. He only got just the little section, the front section done before they moved out. And then it just kind of sat empty. The kids used it for youth group. They would come out and like have little Zen nights.
Yeah. And then it's when got Carol, a good vibe. A few times when Carol and Peter, your brother, your sister and brother-in-law, our sister and brother-in-law, I guess I'd say, they travel all over the country and kind of all over the world. They live in their Jeep and their RV. And
what's it called though?
Overlanding. They do overlanding.
Is it
epic family road trip?
Oh yeah, amazing story. If you get a chance to follow them or venture with their little family story, they do. Their kids are just, I mean, they're just so talented. They have amazing photography. It's out in the woods. It's just gorgeous. They do some amazing shoots and get to travel all over actually. But they have a great YouTube. Anyways, they come and stay with us whenever they're here because they're originally from Canada. And so it's just nice to have a little family spot. Well, this last time they came, which was before COVID, Christmas, right?
Yeah, Christmas before COVID. Time, right before COVID.
Yeah, so they came and stayed with us, and Jay and I worked day and night just cleaning it up. It was horrible.
It was
bringing in like furniture and like vacuuming and oh my god, it was just a big mess.
I rented a storage unit.
We rented a storage unit
it
kind of spurred us on to think, you know, we should make this a really nice place. And so we kind of had that thought in mind when during COVID, a very good friend of mine, I actually used to babysit her, came with her three kids just to come visit the farm. We had the farm stand open. People were coming and getting ranunculus and anemones, and I think peonies started blooming, and they wanted to see the animals, so they came out, and she basically just came and asked us really politely and nicely, hey, and we get this question all the time, what do you do with that yurt?
Right.
And a lot of times our answer is,
we're
not
sure
what to do.
We'll do something.
We want to make it really nice. We just haven't had the means or the time to do it. So.
And I just got laid off, so it was kind of like, you know, she asked us, well, if you think about renting it out, let me know. She's been wanting to go tiny, and this was a good opportunity for her. And she, you know, she wasn't quite sure how it worked, and this was a perfect opportunity. So, kind of forced us to go and remodel it, being I wasn't working. I took about 30 days, and we got it. I put a loft in it and a bathroom. Keep in mind what it had to start with was a hot water heater and a sink and a refrigerator.
And a whole bunch of bugs.
Yeah. Oh, the stink bugs.
What do they call
those? Box overbugs? Yeah. The stink bugs are horrible.
No one ever was in there.
But we took care of that. But we've been collecting stuff. A friend of ours that remodeled her kitchen, we went over there and grabbed some of the...
That was like a year or two before.
Yeah, we grabbed her kitchen sink, which was really nice.
She has like a $1 million house
stuff.
She was redoing her kitchen. So she was pulling it all out. And so we benefited from some of the cabinetry and kitchen stuff.
Yeah.
And so it was really nice of her. She's like, just take what you want. We're like, okay. And we knew eventually we wanted to do some work on the yurt. So we just kind of, again, stored it in there. Jay worked really hard. He would get up. He would be like a flower farmer. He would wake up super early in the morning.
I would just try and get as much done as I could. And I'm not like, I mean, I guess I'm not a like expert carpenter, but I mean, I have done some woodworking stuff, so I kind of know what I'm doing. So I put in the bathroom, and Braden helped me a little bit, and then, ordered all the lumber from local lumber companies. And I wanted to put tongue and groove 2x6 lumber on the in the loft, and it was so expensive to cover that area. But I found a lumber company that they gave me 2x8 tongue and groove. They're 12-foot boards, and it cost me a third of what it would have cost me to get the 2x6. So I took the drive. It was a two-hour round trip to the lumber mill. And
yeah, but you made it a good time.
Yeah, it was
you,
a good time.
Did you take Riley or Braden?
Yeah, I took Riley with me.
Yeah. And there wasn't a lot of things open, so you found like a cute little coffee shop that had like antiques and fun little things like that. And I remember Riley calling me she just had such a good time taking a little road trip early in the morning. Kids always love that, you know, and she's older. She's like 20 something.
Right.
But she was just excited to go on a date with Dad. And you made it really good for her.
No, yeah, we got down there and got it back. And the one bad thing is a friend that does a lot of contract work, he kind of looked at the wood and stuff, and it wasn't dried or anything like that. So
we laid it out in the greenhouse, didn't we?
Well, we laid it out as much as we could, but even like today, it's been now, 9 months since we built that? And I can tell there's been some shrinkage on the flooring and stuff like that. But, you know, it is a yurt when all said and done. So it is what it is. But we did.
That was the loft that you did, right?
I found some actual logs. I wanted kind of a rustic kind of cabin look to the post that for the loft, and found a guy that makes log furniture, and he sold me a couple really nice logs that were barked and
they have a lot of character.
Bare wood.
They are actually one of my favorite pieces in the year, and I was glad we spent the money. So we got a few things like we found a fridge on Craigslist. We found a sink for the bathroom. Somebody had given us a closet tub, so we scrubbed that down. It had kind of chipped and peeling paint on the bottom, and we painted it black on the bottom, kind of like a dull feel to it.
Kind of like a cast iron kind of black color.
Yeah, it was really pretty.
Stuck that in there. And then in the bathroom, we put a composting toilet.
And we went back and forth on this. We watched a lot of YouTube videos.
So we went with, I think it's Airhead brand. It's actually, they're designed, you know, for, you can put it in yachts and stuff like that in boats. So it's not like your bucket on the floor kind of deal. And here's some sawdust. And Olivia's been fine with it. I mean, she does have, there's four girls that live in there, so she does have to be careful of the urine trap and not be overfill that. It becomes a mess.
So what difference would it be if there was four boys living there? Would they, like, overfill it too?
Well, guys would just go outside and third tree on the right, so they wouldn't use it as much.
Oh, that's true. The composting toilet took a little bit of getting used to for them. They had researched it as well because we gave them kind of an option since they were the first ones to stay in the yurt. They've adapted to it and they've done great. Then the other thing,
pellet stove.
Yeah, we did.
So it had a wood burning stove in it. It was just this big monster of a stove.
From like the 70s.
And it was just, it's heavy.
The 70s is bad. It's just.
So, and I've stayed out there at night in the wintertime, and you don't want to have to get up in the middle of the night and have to worry about keeping the fire going. So that was one of the musts that we decided. And we didn't buy the top of the line. I mean, it was about $1,000, but we found a pellet stove that could fit within our budget. And the hardest part was having to, redo the pipe and everything like that. That was a learning curve. I had to redo it like three times. And that pipe is not cheap. That was an expensive adventure. But we got it working properly. And so now she buys her own pellets, and she can fill it up before she goes to bed and keep the heat going, and not have to worry about it being cold in there in the morning.
It actually works really, really well.
Yeah, so
this year, what we want to do is we are going to add a couple, at least one air conditioner, and it's like a good kind. And then you're going to do some windows? Is that what you said?
Yeah, I've been doing some research, and I want to put real glass windows, like vinyl windows in there. I want, but it's, you know, the challenge is putting flat windows on a round surface. So, again, I got reaching out to a construction buddy of mine that he actually came out and helped me with running the plumbing and some of the electrical, and he helped me like hang the doors and do some of the finish work on the yurt. But so that's going to be the challenge, is putting a flat window on a round surface.
So landscaping, it's got some like pear and apple trees that they planted along it. This summer we planted a couple lemon cypresses and some rose bushes out back, and I put in a couple like bay laurels. And then it had this big, huge, like round water tank trough thing that you would use, like it's galvanized. And it was there as well. It was part of their water system because it has rain barrels off of it as well. So anyways, there was nothing kind of in this like tank. So I planted it full of herbs, and we put in a few tomatoes and that kind of thing, just like a small mini kitchen garden off the back. And then Jason finished the deck. But I want to put in my ultimate dream is to do an outdoor shower.
Yeah, that was the one thing we've been wanting to do from the beginning. Is just be able to go out there and just, I don't know, just take a shower.
Well, I mean, half the time I'm like covered in mud and dirt. So at the end of the day of farming, and it would be nice to have like a place I could go just to kind of shower off before I actually come into the house all filthy. But, and two, I mean, that's so fun.
It's cool. I'm taking
and then Brayden and I have been designing and dreaming and planning for probably since we moved in to put a little pond in with a little water feature. Now, I'm a little bit weird about water features because I want them to feel like they were actually supposed to be here. So a very natural looking. And so that part I'm still kind of stumped on. So if you have any ideas, you can put them in the comments below. That would be great. And in fact, while we're on the subject, anytime you see our videos, that does kind of help support our little channel that we've started. If you left us little notes, and we would love to hear from you, and I always respond. I think the ultimate end, I guess when we first came here, we were like, what do we do with this yurt that's purple?
Yeah, people say all the time, you should Airbnb it. And so
we do live in wine country. We do have a lot of, actually there's like two other yurts around us that Airbnb out.
They're busy.
And little cabins, they're booked year round. We haven't gone there yet, but what I would really like to do, I think, this is, you guys can chime in on this as well, is just, I think our end goal was just to have a place that people could come and book and stay to
farm
see.
Experience.
Like a farm experience, to see if tiny living is really what they want to do. So they might book it for a weekend or a long weekend or maybe a week to see. Maybe if they got little kids, like she does, like, is this really going to work in 1,000 square foot, you know, or is it 700 square foot
little place? I think it is.
And then, you know, we've got some animals on the farm. We've got farm work. We do a little bit of vegetable and a lot of flowers. And just creating an experience for folks to come out and just see, like, okay, I've always dreamed of living tiny on my own piece of property. Is this really something that we can do? And is it something that I want to do? Because it's a big undertaking to go.
Yeah. And we get people that mm-hmm. say, hey, could I just come out and work with you for a day or whatever? And we could, you know, give them a place to stay, provide them some meals.
Because a lot of times they're from pretty far away. I mean, we've had local people too, but a lot of times people will reach out to us and just say, I just want to come experience the farm. And so our end goal is to make it that it's a little bit more like that. We also, I mean, our daughter would love to move
out
there.
Yeah, our daughter and her cousin.
Yeah, they both work on the farm here, and they in their dreams, they would love to live out there. But it is a really, really special space, as you can see from the photos and video that we're showing you now.
Okay, I am inside the yurt doing some work, and it is hailing like crazy right now. It's so loud in here. Oh man. It's super loud.
Hello, this is Jason.
You're so good. This is Jason from Yurt Life. No, you're supposed to say, hello, this is Jason from Yurt Life.
Yurt Life?
Oh, yeah. Yurt Life. And we can have, like, you know, music from, you know, like, Days of Our Lives. Welcome. Why would you offend someone?
Hi, this is Jason from Yurt Life.
Yurt Life.
Yurt Life.
Yurt Life. So what we've decided is some of these windows, because we do get rain here at times that can be kind of like sideways, it does come in if we don't have it secured. And we can get those storms sometimes in the summer or spring when it's warm and you want to have these open. There are several things we can do, but what we've chosen to do, see, I'm trying to be like all technical and everything. What we've chosen to do is go ahead and start putting a window, an actual window in at a time as we can afford it.
Right, and so just looking at this here, I just realized that we put a real window on this spot. These 2x4s would come out of here, and that means I would have to move this lovely thing, and maybe the light, but
yeah.
Minor details.
Those are things that as you're going, you realize, you know, any construction, you're like, dang it, I did that wrong. But that's okay, honey. You've done a lot of good things.
I'm a professional.
Okay. Well, we hope you enjoy the video of the yurt, and we're sure excited to see friends come and go and stay with us and people just to be able to experience the farm in the future.
Yeah, and we have some other projects coming up that we want to continue redoing on the year, so we'll share those as they come up.
Yeah, there's always room for improvements, right?
Yep.
So anyways, thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video and you liked watching Jay and I be weird, and give us a thumbs up, give us a comment, like, or even tell us what you liked about the year. We would love to hear from you.
Or tell your friends.
Yeah, or tell your friends. Yeah,
right,
share
thank
it.
You.
That's a share. I think that's
okay,
a share.
Bye.
Okay, bye-bye.